Well, happy Thursday, everyone. Our weather is still very pleasant. We're still getting those nice, brisk mornings and those warmer afternoon and early evening time frame. It's going to be sunny and dry all the way through the weekend, but we are going to begin to see some changes as we'll add a degree or two to the forecast every day until we get back to about 90 degrees by next week. So the heat is coming back. We'll talk about that in a second. Let's first get you caught up on Tropical Storm Fiona. Winds have been pretty much sustained at 50 miles per hour as it moves to the west this weekend. It's going to move over the San Juan Islands, and look at this. As of right now, it could actually skirt Hispaniola. Now, traditionally, hurricanes are tropical systems that go over this. You can't really tell here. We've got some very high mountain ranges, 10,000 feet and above in some locations, and that's nicknamed the Hurricane Shredder. If this does avoid that and stays out in the water, well, then we could see some strengthening, possibly almost hurricane strength by early next week as it gets back out in the Atlantic. Now, where does it go from there if that happens? Well, you could see our weather models pretty much focus that it is going to move to the north and very likely out toward Bermuda. Let me start with this one model. This is the GFS or the American model. I'm going to tell you right off the bat, this is the outlier. This right here probably will not happen, but this has it moving out to the north toward Bermuda and then kind of skirting out to the west a bit. This would be by next Sunday. So, you know what, 7, 8, 9, 10 days out. Again, that probably won't happen. I think what's most likely to happen is going to be what the European model is disclosing here, and a lot of our weather models agree. I think the dynamics are more in place for this particular scenario, and that is, here is our tropical storm that pushes to the north, and then our steering wheel winds pull it out more toward Bermuda. So again, that seems to be the most likely scenario, but we will continue to track in and of course keep you updated. In the meantime, here and now, we've got dry conditions all across the region, from the mountains all the way down to the coast. No drop of rain. In fact, as we head into this weekend, if you are heading to the coast, you might see a stray shower in Charleston or further south, but other than that, not a washout. It's not going to last long, and I think most stay dry. As we go into early next week, even the mid to latter part of next week, look at that. Not much rain in sight. We've got very strong ridge of high pressure that is very much in control. And even as we have a frontal system that tries to come in early next week, looks like it might stall out and really doesn't. I don't see much of a chance of rain at this point. So temperatures will continue to climb. Not much in the way of rain to cool us down. So by Tuesday and Wednesday, Wednesday being the final day of summer, we could have highs back in the low 90s. In the mountains, look at that. Not quite as warm, but highs getting close to 90 by Tuesday of next week.